We're on our field trip to the Arbuckle Mountains in southern Oklahoma. We are along Interstate 35, so you're going to hear some road noise as cars and trucks go by, including an occasional honk or two. I also have some students with me, Shannon, Dustin, and Allie. This is our first stop on the field trip, and what we're going to look at here is what's called an angular unconformity, which is right up here. And let me explain what we have here. First, you'll notice the lower part of this outcrop, you can see some beds. And these beds are dipping like this. They're dipping to the south, which is that direction. They're dipping fairly steeply. They're Ordovician limestones and some shales. But if you go up the outcrop, you'll notice there's a line up there. And at that line, you don't see dipping rocks anymore. You see a different rock type. That rock type up there is a conglomerate, pieces of other rocks. You'll notice that some of them are rounded. That contact between the conglomerate and the rocks underneath is called an angular unconformity. So we're going to talk now about, and I'm going to have the students help me go through this, about the events that occurred to produce this angular unconformity. But before I do that, a little bit about an angular unconformity. Why is it important? Because it tells us about the history of the rock and the succession, and it also represents a time gap. Something's missing, and we'll come back to that point. So let's now talk about the succession of events that produce this particular outcrop in southern Oklahoma in the Arbuckle Mountains. So I'll ask the students, what was the first event that formed here that started off this sequence? Deposition of what?
These underlying beds.
Okay. Which are limestones, all right? Where do limestones form today?
In the ocean.
Where in the ocean?
Shallow, shallow water.
Shallow, warm water. So if you want to go study where these limestones are forming today, where would you go?
The Bahamas.
The Bahamas.
Okay. Tough places to go for field trips. That'll be our next field trip. All right, so the limestones were formed and they were laid down horizontally. Then what happened?
Deformation.
Okay, what's deformation?
Tilting of the layers.
The tilting of the layers. What caused those tilting? Well, you had a deformational or an orogenic event, and that event was probably the Ouachita orogeny, which occurred about 300 million years ago, and that's when South America and Africa hit North America, or what is now North America, and caused deformation and compression and tilted these rocks. So the rocks were tilted up, and then what happened?
It planed off at the top.
By what processes?
Erosion.
By erosion, okay? So you had uplift, the internal processes we've talked about in the class before. Then you had erosion, those external processes, which are caused by water and so on. You had erosion and you produced conglomerate, which deposited right on top of these tilting beds. And the conglomerate's called the Collins Ranch conglomerate. We're going to see it in the next stop as well.